Her Excellency Linda Taglialatela has been serving as the U.S. Ambassador to the OECS and Barbados for the past 5 years. She was appointed in 2016 by then-President Barack Obama, served through the entire Trump administration, and will now serve under the presidency of Joe Biden.
I have to tell you, this has been one of the most amazing experiences of my life. I grew up in a little town in upstate New York, and I was thinking about what I was dreaming of when I grew up, and I don't even think I knew what an ambassador was. And then, you know, so many years later in a career, I have the most incredible opportunity to represent my country in Barbados and the Eastern Caribbean, to include St. Lucia. And it has truly been an honor and, as I said, an amazing experience.
St. Lucia and the rest of her OECS counterparts can look forward to deepening U.S. interest in the sub-region with a primary focus on climate change, says the ambassador.
The three presidents that I've worked for have been interested in the Caribbean. President Biden, you may not know, but when he was the vice president, he and President Obama had basically divvied up the world, and Vice President Obama was focused on Latin America and the Caribbean. And he made a number of trips to the region, and he obviously was very familiar with the key issues. So we can be very happy to know that President Biden is very well attuned to Latin America and the Caribbean and what is of importance to them. I think one of the major issues that's going to be focused on places like the Caribbean and has become a top priority for this administration is climate change.
St. Lucia, however, should not look forward to sanctions and local law enforcement being lifted by President Biden. The statutory provisions of the Leahy law does not permit a sitting president to unilaterally reverse a decision to impose it, the ambassador has explained. This can only occur when the secretaries of defense and state determine that the government of that country, St. Lucia in this case, has taken or is taking effective measures to address the issues that led to its application in the first place. Local police was banned from receiving security-related assistance from the U.S. under the law after being accused of gross human rights violations. The U.S. and the local government have been working together to lessen some of these restrictions.
We understand and believe that most St. Lucia police are law-abiding, responsible officers, but unfortunately the Leahy law is focused on accountability. And it is a law which Mr. Biden cannot, in any, President Biden in no way can forgive. We have worked with the DPP to help him with some of his evidence, but beyond that, we are not involved in the cases or the prosecution of any individual. That is a St. Lucian sole area of responsibility. I know that they have been working on it. I am not sure what the status of the cases are. That would be something to take up with the DPP. I am hopeful that they will be able to move forward. And we have been working with the St. Lucian government to find and to look at ways to reduce the restrictions. One of the ways, obviously, is creating the border security control unit that they're working on.
Given the restrictions on movement as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic, the ambassador has not been able to visit St. Lucia and the other islands within her jurisdiction, but she is looking forward to doing so once things normalize. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.